Ladies and gentlemen, Metropolitan Room is proud to present Two Blondes.
Thank you so much for coming. Before we begin, we should probably tell you what we're going to be doing our show about. Everyone's been like, what's your show about?
We want to know.
And we're like, please, first of all, don't speak to us that way. And second of all, it is very hard coming up with original ideas.
It's like everything's been done before.
No, literally.
We had this hilarious idea for two dudes that were into Barbies.
Do you remember that? We were going to call it Guys and Dolls.
That's a show.
It's a show.
That we've actually both been in.
Twice.
I love you. Bush Limpet.
Same different concept. That's where the confusion came from.
And then we had that hilarious idea. Do you remember?
Oh, yeah. Me and Savannah both grew up in Southern California dancing. And we were always always amazed at how many Mormons there were at our dance studio. So we were like, what if we do a show where we take these Mormons, go on their mission to Africa or wherever and teach dance, tap dance.
Tap dancing Mormons.
But it's been done.
It's been done. Apparently there's a Tony Award winning musical called Book of Mormon on Broadway right now.
Oh my God, it's like, when does it end? The only good thing that came out of this was realizing that our ideas were in sync with Tony Award winning ideas. So that's pretty cool. Not to toot our own horn, but toot.
Finally, after thinking long and difficult,
and hard is the same. We finally came up with an idea that has never been done before because it's our own story. We call it Life in Our 20s. Life in our 20s. Okay, so I was worried you said the 20s.
What did you say?
I said life in our 20s, because we're in our 20s, and our original idea was to tell a story about us pursuing our dreams in our 20s.
Okay, see, when you said 20s, I thought you meant the decade.
I meant the age.
Okay, see, when you said age, I thought you meant the age of flappers and jazz music.
I guess it makes sense now why you insisted on wearing that outfit. It's fine. I'm just gonna jump right in.
Okay, I'm just gonna follow along. I'm gonna make it real tight.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right.
Said I could be anything. I really took that to heart. Decided I'd be a star.
The 1920s brought about several novel and highly visible social and cultural trends.
Okay, so we're not doing it on the 1920s, as we just discussed.
Okay.
Every school play, graduated with the top GPA. Then I studied theater, got my BFA. Next stop, Broadway.
In the 1920s, jazz blossomed and Art Deco peaked. For women, knee-length skirts became socially acceptable, as to the bobbed hair with the Marcel wave.
Did you really learn all of that?
Yeah.
I mean, that's really impressive. Wikipedia?
Yahoo Answers.
You know, for the sake of this song, why don't you just try to follow along?
Okay.
And even though people warned me that life in the real world's hard,
so hard.
Told me that I'd be a star. So when I graduate, life is gonna be misled. I should have dreamt of being a nanny instead, 'cause the day I turned 20, everything changed. The beautiful color. theater major. Okay, fine. What really happened went something like this. I graduated college and my plan went amiss. I thought I'd be killing the audition scene, but I barely go out, and when I do, I'm green. And everyone's a model, so I try to stay slim, but it's hard when you like pizza more than hitting the gym. And what's up with acne at 23? Wasn't that supposed to be a thing in my teens? And you need clear skin to book a TV show, so in the meantime, got a hostess job to earn some dough, but it doesn't pay enough to live on my own. So my cool roommates are my parents at home. And let me tell you, prohibition is tough, especially when you're dreaming of Savannah. I think we're doing two different shows. This is our first time doing a cabaret, so just bear with us. Hopefully there won't be any more confusion.
Chase, speak for yourself. I'm a cabaret expert.
Isn't this your first cabaret as well?
Yeah, but I've seen tons. I come from a long line of cabaret artists. My mom, my aunt, my other aunt, my grandma, my two-year-old cousin.
It's really young.
I actually have a cheat sheet to keep us on track.
It's like you're Vanna White.
Oh. My name's Savannah Brown.
It was a joke. I know your name. Never mind. Okay, so great. Opening number. Check. Just did that. Band introductions. Do you want to introduce the band?
I would, but I don't remember their names.
Okay. This is Oliver.
Hello. Hi, Oliver. That is so weird. That's the name of my next boyfriend.
That is my boyfriend, Savannah. You know this? He's just like doing us a favor.
Hey, nice to meet you. I'm Matthew.
Oh, I knew that. I was at the tip of my toes.
Tip of your tongue.
Savannah hired me? I assume she told you.
Nope.
Well, it's nice to meet you. What do you do?
I'm an actress.
Cool. Have you been anything I would have heard of?
What?
Have you been anything I maybe would have seen?
Like, I'm literally on stage doing a show right now that you're kind of interrupting, so.
Well, I mean, like, more along the lines of TV or Broadway.
Have you been in anything?
Sure. I just got back from a tour with the Philharmonic. I was in London with a music festival. I worked with Idina Menzel on the Frozen song Let It Go. All before the age of 20.
Oh. How old are you now?
20.
Oh, for you. Where'd you find this guy, Savannah?
On Craigslist.
Turning 22, and I don't know what to do, because I had big plans, I'd already be famous. 21, I was fine. Borderline. 22, I'm past my prime. I'm running out of time to become famous. I should be famous. So this show is for you and you and you. Not so much you, but stay anyway. You need a crowd. And you, my last chance to prove what I can do. And by the time we're through, you'll think, why isn't this girl famous? Let's make her famous. Okay? Okay? Okay. Well, see, watch this.
know all about that. If you wanna put on a cabaret show, there's a few things you need to know. I'll catch you up to speed, just follow my lead, and you're sure to have a hit show. First thing, glamour and pearls for every showgirl. Throw in a boa and you'll have it made. The band should be cute, but keep them mute. It's fine, guys. They're the only ones getting paid. Simply entertaining. When you don't know what's next, drink champagne. What's next? I'm turning 22. Actually, 24. And you don't know.
We were both blonde, we both were dancers that were studying theater, and we were both, surprisingly enough, in the same sorority.
We were both an Alpha Phi.
We were the Alpha Phis, the silver and we're dope. We wear the ivy leaves, and we want you to know we love A-L-P-H-A-P-H-I, Alpha Phi, A-L-P-H-A-P-H-I-P! Woo!
Yeah. I'm Emma, and I'm here, you're in a sorority. Oh, you must be super down to earth. No, we just loved drinking.
Loved it.
But now that we're out of college, it's just like, ew,
over it. I don't want it anymore.
We hate it. So mature.
Just the shots that you guys asked for.
What? We didn't ask for those.
Yeah, they told me to keep them coming all night.
Like, we're not gonna waste it. There's a drought.
In California, there's a drought.
We'd love to play a drinking game with you guys. So here are the rules. Basically, every time we like talk about a new category, you'll take a drink.
Every time you say a word.
So yeah, there's a word there, you'll drink. Shall we practice? So here I go.
Word.
And we drink.
Yeah.
How much fun?
It's mandatory.
Mandatory drinking game. But, I don't know. When you're in your early 20s, drinking is practically unavoidable. For example, when I say the number 21, what comes to mind?
Hitler.
What?
Hitler joined the Nazi party in 1921.
No.
Prohibition.
Closer, but no, Savannah, I thought we were on the same page about what this show's about.
I know, I forgot.
I know you did a lot of research about the 1920s, but like, do you know anything about life in your 20s?
I know my fair share of Taylor Swift.
Okay, but that's a start.
Seems like one of those nights, this place too crowded, too many cool kids.
and she was
not born.
It seems like last night we ditched the whole scene and end up dreaming instead of sleeping.
I hear in my mind all these voices. I hear in my mind all these words. I hear in my mind all this music.
Nobody fully. Always one foot.